Because you can do so many affiliate codes, but if you have no sales, you're not an affiliate. People don't understand. You're not an influencer if you don't actually have influence over people. Just because you bought likes and followers make you an influence, it just doesn't, okay? It's so cool. Good morning, vlog. It is currently 6:30 a.m. And if you are doing anything in regards to social media, this video is for you because today we're going to experiment at the gym. There's so much time wasted replying to emails. Emails are so hard for me. I don't like reading, but I realize if I can multitask, you know, that'd be so cool. Like one day in the future, Alexa can like use her AI and reply to for all of them for me. But like for now, how cool would it be if I was able to reply to emails while working out? Like I could work while working out. So today we're going to the gym. I brought my laptop. Hopefully I'll make it there in one piece because these like icicles are like really concerning. But that's the agenda for today. I'm gonna see how I can work and work out. I totally hope you guys get some value out of this. OOTD, 30 degrees here in Portland, Oregon. So we're gonna see if I can put my computer on my treadmill. It's like really stable too. Do you see that? And it just like hooks it perfectly. I rate this 10 out of 10. You need to do this. I think I'm gonna power through. This is dope. Oh my god. So it's currently been 43 minutes. I recommend it. I have a meeting on the treadmill. So yeah, I have a meeting right now. Back from the gym, you know, I'm literally super fueled up, I guess. I didn't get that much work because the entire time I was just like working out. But I did email people and I was hearing out so many of your guys' interest for people who wanted to join my like guinea pig team for my app. Besides that, I was reading DMs and I just realized like people are interesting. And most people, when they ask me for questions, like most of them are bullshit, like how do I get this? But some of them are actually very meaningful to me because you guys have real situations I can relate to, and all I want to do is help you guys just open up to me, like literally paragraphs at some point. People are so caught up in like hitting your first 10k followers on Instagram or like your first 1,000 on YouTube or whatever that means, and how much your Snapchat, the new update will like basically disintegrate Snapchat's like net worth. But anyways, what happened to just getting your first 100 followers, like your first 102 fans? People are always measuring the wrong thing, and deep down the real problem is actually making money or fixing the relationship with a friend and or like a parent. They think money and numbers or numerical things will fix that, and it's not true. So although I give a lot of like how to get, you know, 10k on Instagram and how to do this, my main objective is to help you guys realize your biggest problem and help you fix that, because it's more often than not that your real problem is something that has to do with the psychology of you and your future or something like that. So I'm hungry, I'm gonna go back home. Back home, I'm getting ready. It's only 9 a.m., which leaves me 2 hours before my next meeting, and then I have an appointment at 12. So you guys, I wanna chat. For my guys and girls that like the business jade, you can skip a link of time below where you can just skip this part, because I'm just gonna talk about what I do in life and what I really love. One of my subscribers were asking me like, Jay, where do you get your clothes? And I really am sad to say, like, I thrift a lot. Like, this was from Goodwill, this was from Goodwill, and my top was from PacSun. But like, most of my clothes are thrifted, so I really can't recommend anything. I'm not stingy. With myself, at least. A subscriber was asking about my skincare, and I was like, you know what? I kind of talk about life sometimes. So I really swear by this product, and you can buy this on Amazon. So I'll link it below. It's called the Boscia White Charcoal Mattifying Spray. Do yourself a favor if it's a girl's day, and guys, like, I'm telling you, if you have acne, this shit, like, it's a little bougie and it feels really good. I'm obsessed with it. I use it every day, every night. I thought I'd recommend a product you can actually get. So I'll link it below. It's an affiliate link, and if you don't want to use it, it's okay. In regards to everything else, like, most of my makeup's old, most of my clothes are used. The one thing I do invest in occasionally is skincare. So I really like this. Okay, that was all for today's plug. I'm gonna get ready, and I'll catch you guys when I'm done. Okay, Google, stop. So I've been like working just for a little bit, answering emails, and most of them are you guys, but some of them are my school. Basically yesterday, my mom had to go to school, poor mother, and they're like, yeah, dropping out of school is illegal. You're gonna go to jail. I was like, what the fuck? I wasn't like that, but we weren't able to talk to the principal who actually makes the decisions. But yeah, now my other teachers are like, Jay, like, we have to submit it to the admin of the state so I can still like join this club for my friend. So yeah, are you enrolled in school? Will you be enrolled in school this year? No. But no one ever knows that I have a business, so they think I'm like a lazy ass person at home. YouTube's my full-time job. So a lot of you guys wanted to send me stuff, especially brands, and there's no way I'm giving out my address because I'm literally scared to death already just going outside. I've got a P.O. box and I will see how it goes. I've never done this before. Let's see if I can get my P.O. box. So we're getting the P.O. box. My mom's behind the camera. Say hi.
Hi.
What? This always happens, right? Today, it was a fail. PO box was not accomplished, but I did need to Literally, the U.S. wants to kill me. I swear we're getting in a car accident.
Well, a car almost hit us. I got a question from Tristan. I'm going to pick you. I usually will pick a question from a DM that I get that's really good and spot on. Here it is. So I'm an athlete cycling all around the world, representing Canada and trying to share my experiences with my audience. I've been building my Instagram around this sport, but now I feel like I need some tips on what to do next because content isn't really a problem since I'll be traveling so much. It's about what to aim for. Sponsors, promote, brands. Okay, Tristan, good question. I think some of you guys need a better understanding on how to fuel your life. Everyone thinks money is a bad thing. It's like evil, but like you need to eat. Like money is energy to do what you want to do. So this is the steps, okay? It starts with what you have. Content, distribution, monetization. So let me explain. Content, okay? Tristan, you sound like an expert at it. You have pictures, you travel, content is bomb, people like it. You get good content because you post good shit. The next step after that is distribution. You can always go back and forth between content and distribution, those stages. Are you in enough Facebook ads? Like, do you promote your product or yourself onto other shout out pages? But do you know what I'm saying? If you have to distribute your content, how are you doing it? Are you in any forums, Reddit? Are you replying to people's comments? So I would keep doing that. Keep building your audience to whatever number makes you happy. You really only need 1,000 true fans, and these true fans are people that will cut their arm off to hang out with you. Like, the way you get 1,000 true fans, by the way, is my content and distribution. So I would keep doing content distribution. Now monetization is the third step. Usually people go to monetization way too early. Like literally, you need to stay on those two first steps for the next like long time, okay? Until you have your true fan base. The next steps, back to your question, I think you need to basically DM 100 brands that you like. Just DM or email. You can use my email script if you'd like. And just understand, you have to know how many people you accumulated through your content distribution that are actually like caring about you and that would basically do whatever you say. For example, if you partnered with REI and REI made you pose with a really cool outfit and you just posted a picture. So I would DM REI and in mind with a project like that, like you have a photographer and you're just like, yo, I'll mention you. And if you give me $1,200 to post a picture, I will bring you 10x, which is 1200. So this only works if you understand how many people that actually care about you. In regards to your question, like what do you do with the fan base you have? You wanna test who's the bullshit people and who the people that actually will listen to you, aka people who are serious and people who aren't. So I would basically do like Instagram polls. I would do a lot Instagram live, see who actually really cares and shows up to those kind of, you know, social media things. And then if you post a product, let's see who actually buys. When you have to pull out your wallet, it's a whole different game. Right now people can like and comment posts, like engagement is engagement, but it's a whole different level when you have to pull out your credit card. So I would say, Tristan, I would DM 100 brands you want to work with, monetize, see who's legitimate, and then once you have a few brand promotions, you're able to literally go up to anyone because your social proof is high enough. You can go up and speak in bike conferences. I don't know, okay? I just know because I do marketing for e-commerce brands. They have like a lot of trade shows and they have to like work with textile companies. But the best source of income is affiliate marketing, at least for what I'm hearing from you. Speaking, holding your events, there's so much money. You can start a podcast, you can make a little YouTube, you can cross platform. Monetizing is easy. Like monetizing is honestly the easiest part. What's harder is distribution and seeing who's loyal, because you can do so many affiliate codes, but if you have no sales, you're not an affiliate. People don't understand you're not an influencer if you don't actually have influence over people. Just because you bought likes and followers make you an influence, it just doesn't, okay? So that's what I would do, Tristan. I hope this was helpful and I like your question. Time to go to the next appointment.
Waiting to get the lashes done. Ooh, they look shitty right now. Oh, these lashes are on. What do you guys think? What do you guys think? So they're on, but it was painful. So a little backstory. I got my lashes first done in LA. So I was like, why not get them retouched at this place that was brutally cheap? And I was like, why not? Like, I'm on a budget. Sure. If you guys don't know, eyelash extensions are like when they glue the hairs like one by one. So I went to the place. It was great. Like, she's so nice, but I don't know why it was so freaking painful. Like, I wanted these things. Brushes for your lashes. Yeah, kind of like started jabbing it into my eye and I was like, okay, this is unpleasant. Like, it felt like a cheese grater. Like, someone was like aggressively rubbing it on my eyes. After that was fine. It took 2 hours and I paid with all dollar bills. Like, I didn't have $20 bills around me. I gave her a tip. I was nice, but I was like, damn, this is painful. Anyways, congratulations to the comment winner.
Shout out to the comment winner. Comment on this post to be featured in the next episode.
Comment how your day was and what do you think about these lashes. It was freaking painful. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. I have these things to do. I have to reply to DMs. I have to reply. Oh, I have to edit a video for the app. And then, yeah. So I'll catch you guys in tomorrow's video. Hopefully my PO box gets fixed. I love you all so, so much. Thank you so much for watching. Give this video a like and subscribe and listen to Drop Shipping Dropout on iTunes and SoundCloud. I think I'll be ready by this time. So, catch you guys in the next one. Goodbye.